Welcome back, everybody.
The man himself.
Got a short part coming up. Basically just going to finish up this area for a little bit. And to do that, let's talk to Sultan and see what he wants. So he likes that we're new around here, asks us if we want to get some money. Given that he's dressed like a bandit, probably can't be anything good. I am insulting. You want me to do what? I'm sorry, Sultan, but that's murder, and killing people is wrong.
A good time.
I'm telling Beard on you.
Welcome aboard our swamp.
Alright, so we're gonna help out the stalkers here by going underground. We're playing the role of a double agent, and given that we are a military man posing as a stalker who's now posing as a bandit betraying the stalkers, who's actually a stalker betraying the bandits trying to betray the stalkers. I guess that makes us a quintuple agent, then.
We'll give it to him good.
Hey, what's going on?
Take a chill pill, man. We'll take them easy.
Damn, I already used my walk the dinosaur joke in the last Let's Play. Well.
Come on, you next here!
Surprise. Apparently, going back to talk to the guys that you were planning to betray right after you told me your plan was actually me betraying you. We didn't become a secret agent by accident, you know. We know how it works. These guys actually have some pretty good conditioned weapons, so might as well take these and try to sell them off. You might notice that I've got a bit of extra money right now, and
thanks for your help.
That is because I actually went out and did a little bit of hunting. Found some cool stuff. Some artifacts. Some weapons. A little bit of baloney, but not too much. And so we got a little bit of money from the reward, and we also got stash information. And unfortunately, I am over encumbered, so screw the AK. Really don't care about it right now. Wow. You know, I'm kind of wondering how I am still over encumbered, even though I don't have any extra weapons. But maybe the fact that I have got 800 bullets for the AK in my inventory has something to do with it. I honestly have no idea how I came across all that ammunition, but well, I guess it's useful if I need it. Ever. Okay, so welcome to night in Call of Pripyat. It is very dark. Very, very, very dark. Fortunately, we don't have to move around too much with it. And here's the stash, pretty easy to find. It is an LR-300, some bandages, and can't really get this last bit. It's some ammo for the LR-300. Sometimes getting things out of the stash can be a little finicky because it gets stuck. You have to find a really good angle. But we got the ammo. Just an ordinary, run-of-the-mill LR-300, so I'm gonna take all the ammo out of it, and wait a minute, I recognize this place. We went here in the very first episode, which means, oh god, it's even worse at night. Yeah, let's get out of here before it decides to jump off the wall.
Hey, Stalker, how are you?
As we'll ask around about Magpie a little bit. It seems that people have heard about him, but no one really knows where he is.
Howdy,
hello!
Anyway, I guess we got another job from Beard, so might as well follow up on that. This is a follow-up quest to the one that we just did. We have to go meet up with some stalkers to hit the bandits again. Except this time on our terms. Before we do that, sell this LR-300. We don't need it because we've already got an upgraded one. I'm going to sell off a couple hundred rounds because I do not need this ammo.
So, you got anything new?
Now, you might be tempted to sleep at this point so that you can get back to daytime, but we're not going to do that. Because if you sleep, then you automatically fail the mission. Because they just go ahead without you. Of course, we know that if anybody could ever get anything done without our help in this game, then it would probably be over already. Now, I know you can't really see really anything at night here. Honestly, the lighting, it's not as bad as it could be. Because I have it set to more dynamic lighting, so the flashlight will cover more. But if you play this on a bad computer or on just low settings with default light settings, then it is a nightmare to see at night. You literally can only see about 2 feet in front of you. I don't know if you'll be able to see any more on YouTube, but, well, I guess we'll see. I will remedy the nighttime situation later.
Don't let the sentry see you.
I guess we gotta turn the flashlight off. If you couldn't see anything before, then you really won't be able to now. Don't worry, it won't last too long. How are these guys walking so fast when they're crouched? I can't even walk that fast.
What have you got, show me?
Look, we've got these here artifacts. And we can get more of them. In exchange, we're looking for weapons and some good equipment.
You know that I've got whatever loot you've got, so weapons and equipment are not a problem. All my stuff is top quality, no doubt about it.
That clears things up. Take them down!
I do like how they did that, where they really do try to make this game more cinematic than the previous ones. Really helps out with the atmosphere and really gives it a more polished effect overall. Unfortunately, it's so dark in here that we can't even see the dot in the scope for the LR-300. And rather than try to work things out with the duty guy and the mercenaries, we just decide to kill them all. Though I can't... I guess it was unavoidable. And you open fire on in their direction, and I guess you can't help but hit them, or make them think that you're trying to hit them. Don't mind me, give me a second. And that is how you deal with an exosuit. So this guy had 3 weapons on him. The pump action shotgun, he had a AK-74U and an AK-74. That is possible with an exosuit though, as exosuits give you, I think, 30 kilograms extra of carry weight, but you can't sprint with them. Cool, so we got some stash information, some money, and we've got a reward waiting at Beard. And hey, that's convenient. Stash is right next door. I really love the ambient sounds at night. Like the crickets and all the weird, unsettling groans that you can hear. Spaz 12. I don't really want to give up these two shotguns because they're good condition. I'll be able to sell both of them for a decent amount. So I'm going to drink my last Hercules, and I guess I'll be able to probably sell it, or buy another one, I mean, from a vendor. They didn't add too many new aspects with this game. They kind of wanted to keep the same stalker formula that they knew worked, but what they did add actually works, and it makes the game work really well. And they didn't really overpower anything either. They balanced everything out well. It's definitely a very well-made game, and it's sad to say that Stalker 2 apparently is not coming out. At least not anytime soon.
Hello.
Since GSC Game World was dissolved.
What are you? A statue? If you got something, spill the beans. If not, take a hike.
Now, somebody told me that you can actually sell the grenades to stalkers for a good bit more, but honestly, we're getting them so frequently now that I don't think we really have to worry about losing a little bit
of
profit.
Hello! What brings you to our humble vessel?
And it's a lot more convenient to just sell it to someone that you know will buy it. Decent amount of money.
Drop in if something
out the hole.
Won't be going anywhere, that's for sure.
Hey, bro.
So, you managed to drag your
no
ass
hard
over
feeling,
here?
That's right, Sultan. Apparently not. He'll still tell us about his background.
See you. If you manage to stay in one piece, that is.
Wait, where am I going? There's really nothing left for us to do right now, so might as well head on over to the next area, investigate some of the crash sites and the evacuation points. So now we have to talk to this guy to lead us to the new area. Apparently in the middle of a Psy-Storm.
Here we are. Yanov Station is a haven of relative safety in the area around Jupiter. This is where we go our separate ways. But if you need me, look for me by the bar.
Michael Jackson, eat your heart out.
First time here? I'm relatively new here myself. The name's Nitro. I work with equipment. I can repair anything you need. But getting some good tools is a problem around here. If you see anything, bring it straight to me. And if you need any technical help, come see me and I'll be glad to do what I can for you.
It just so happens that we do have some tools. Now that's really going to be about it. I'm going to take a look at some of the people around here, though. Give you a little bit of a very quick crash
course.
What
do I do?
Here.
If I go, I'll lose money. If I don't go, I'll end up dead.
Well, I think that's kind of an obvious answer, then. Let's see what this guy wants.
Okay, I'll tell you how to kill controllers. The other day, I chanced upon a buttload of artifacts and decided to stash them while still en route, because my back couldn't hack it anymore. On the way back, I got to my stash, and there it was, a controller, chilling right on top of it. Now, I thought to myself, controller or no controller, I gotta get my shit back. Then I realized that if I shield myself with something, its manipulation bullshit won't work on me. So, I picked up a metal grate that I found lying around and started sneaking up on the beast. By the time it woke up to what was going on, I'd pumped half a clip into the cocksucker's head. Just as it started trying to control me, I gave it a final bash with my rifle butt, and that was that.
Impressive. And that story sounds kind of familiar, though we can't go any farther with it just
Aloha!
Yet. Oh boy. Somebody who's just as annoying as the guy in the Freedom Base. This is the trader. He will give you, you can sell weapons and ammunition to him and buy food and ammo. Among other things, such as new detector, which I will buy. Now people are probably going to tell me that I could find it in a stash somewhere, but it's convenient this way, and really, it's not that expensive.
Hey, bro.
I still think that we should sell the artifact.
So as you can see, that guy was part of Freedom, and we just saw a duty member in here, so I guess a lot of people are getting along in Call of Pripyat now, where we've got regular stalkers meshing with bandits in that one hideout in the other area, and now we've got Freedom and Duty recruiting in the same spot. This guy gives us a little information about the PDA that we found on the duty guy. And now, give this guy some of those tools, as well as learn a little something about a different kind of tool that he needs from a radio, or he needs radio parts from a cement mixing station, I believe it is. So we can't upgrade the LR-300 anymore, but we do have a new tree unlocked for the SPAS-12. Not going to be unlocking any of that right now, though, because we will be getting a shotgun upgrade soon.
Later.
And that's about it for this part, guys. Pretty short, but kind of had to be to get into the new area. See you next time when we start up this new area.